captured, abandoned, and destroyed Russian vehicles. This video is going to show you a list of all of them, where to get them, where to see them, and how to check it out. So let's get to it. So here is a website that has a listing of all the captured, destroyed, and abandoned Russian and, of course, Ukraine military vehicle. Go ahead, and I'm going to have a link for this down below. If you enjoy this and if you have friends that are interested in this, go ahead and share this video or send them the link, because this is where you can find everything. Okay, so let's go down. Let me show you how to use this site here. You go down here and you find the ones that are captured, and you can open up any one of these like this and take a look at it. Like this, here's one of them. It shows the date that it was captured. And here's another one like this. And you can see these are definitely from Russia. Going down the list, I found some T-90s in here. And this is one of the newer Russian tanks. And here's a look at a T-90 right there. So here's another good armored personnel carrier, the BTR-82A. And this is what it looks like. And here is a good old BTR-MDM. This, as you know, is the villager's choice. If you miss it, I have a video that talks about this. And this is what it looks like. It's an amphibious one. And it can be airdropped and everything. And it is a great vehicle. Seats 13 inside right here. Used by the airborne troops. Look at these captures they got of these. Look at that. Another interesting vehicle is the MRAP right here. These are mine resistance armored personnel carriers. And they got some of these. These are cool looking vehicles. And under here, under infantry mobility vehicles, they have the Gaz Tiger. And what I think is interesting about this is this one gets good gas mileage. And after the war, you could use this because it is basically just about the size of a Hummer. So it could be a good family vehicle. Okay, let's get to something very interesting that you may find kind of cool. Under communication stations, basically this is like a radar, is the Barnaul right here. If you don't know what the Barnaul is, it is this guy right here. And what this is a radar system for low flying objects like UAV. So this is kind of like the opponent of the Barakdar. So we want to get these, as many of these as possible. So these are self-propelled artillery. Why these are important is because Ukraine needs a lot of these, like the Vodzika right here. This thing is self-propelled, and look at it, it's pretty much intact. It's got ammo and everything, but they need this to go on the offense. I'll be making a video about that. And of course, no video is complete without the MSTA series right here. Check this big boy out right over here. Look at that big artillery piece. Now, one of the big prizes out there is the multiple rocket launcher. And the one that I think is a big prize is the Uragan right here. And it's a 220 millimeter. It's an old guy, but look at this. And I don't know why they put it on fire, because can use this thing. Look at this, big old missiles, but these can be used against the Russians. And you all know about the Panzer S1. Look at how many captured. Let's go over to here. Look at these. Wow, these are great anti-aircraft platforms. And down here, of course, look at this, the Krasukha. And this is the famous one. You remember this one here? Fell off a truck, not an 18-wheeler, but a Russian truck. And finally, we have helicopters here. You have the Mi-24 and the Alligator. Okay, so here's the Mi-24. You may have seen this video before, this dramatic video where they shot down two helicopters over a reservoir, and this one over here where these guys were at the Kherson airport and they just left their choppers out there and they got blowed up by the Barakdar. You can see right here that if you want to see Barakdar kills, you can look like this here. If you guys like to see destroyed kills, look this way.